The leader of opposition, Joel Senyonyi, led the team of opposition legislators for an oversight tour at the site for Luowa Super Specialized Hospital in Wakiso District. They, however, arrived at a closed gate manned by police officers.
Hello.
Good morning. How are you?
Fine.
Can we talk to you, sir?
Speaking through a hall, one policeman, known as Mugisa, informed the group that they needed to obtain express permission from the Minister of Health and police to access the facility.
I'm requesting that you open and we talk to you.
Senyonyi and other members of parliament insisted that they had got a clearance form from the Minister of Health, Dr. Jen Ruth Acheng, and presented papers to the gatekeepers who adamantly refused to open.
Even though it is our mandate, we don't just drive our cars and we come here. We inform the necessary stakeholders. As far as we are concerned, the stakeholder for this project is the Ministry of Health, which I did write to the Minister of Health. And the Minister for Health wrote back to me, this is the letter, saying she has received, she had actually wished to be here, but she's attending cabinet. But she says, please go ahead. I wish you success in the tour.
In March 2019, Parliament approved the request by the Minister of Finance to issue promissory notes for the construction of Luowa Hospital, valued at $379.71 million, approximately 1.44 trillion shillings. Today, members of Parliament wondered why public funds are spent on a project which is out of bounds for Parliament's scrutiny.
We're coming here is to do our oversight role. But on our way here, the moment we reached here, they closed the gate. The security agencies which are who are inside, they did not allow us to enter. We are still here, we are still waiting, but this is telling a lot of things.
This specialized hospital has been here, the plan has been here for long. We have spent Ugandans' money on this project, but you see our neighboring countries like Tanzania, their specialized hospital is ready, and many others, and even Ugandans go there to get treatment.
Finance International had promised to construct Luowa Hospital in 2 years, and later run the hospital for 6 years before the hospital reverts back to government. But 5 years later, the project has been engulfed in numerous scandals. Police and UPDF beefed up security at the premises to make matters more complicated for the leader of opposition team.
For now, I will refer you to the ministry to clear you and copy the relevant authorities.
That's which ministry?
Ministry of Health. Copied to other relevant authorities.
Which ones are funded?
Including Parliament itself.
Including Parliament?
We are Parliament.
Yes, you are, but we need a clearance, a clear document.
Cleared by who?
How can we prove at this moment that it is valid?
How are you able to prove that it is not valid?
After hitting a dead end, the opposition decided to advance the matter to the floor of Parliament to push for a halt on further funding of the project and save funds for health center foes.
We want to get back with a report to Parliament telling them that, look, the money that we send to Luowa Hospital, the billions every year, let us stop. Because there's no work going on here at Luowa Hospital. Nothing. Zero, zilch. Even when you stand, you can't see anything, except if they're saying there's an underground hospital, that kind of thing. But if there's anything happening, they would have let us go in there to ascertain and play our oversight role.
We have health centers, 3 and 4s, that are operating and do not have enough machinery and do not have doctors and they do not have medicine. Let the money that these people are going to come and request for at all times be now allocated to those health centers.
Roughly, government has injected over 600 billion shillings in the project, which was meant to carry 54 oncology beds, 27 infectious disease beds, 27 medical beds, 16 VIP beds, 8 ICU beds, as well as 60 outpatient beds, 54 surgery beds, 27 pediatric beds, 27 OBGYN beds, and 16 intensive care, 8 neonatal ICU beds, and 11 operating theatres. Recently, Parliament approved another 2.7 billion shillings for the Minister of Health to supervise stalled construction. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.